it is only the woman's eggs that are aging. Her uterus is not aging. Okay, so if you're even at 50 years of age, if your overall health is okay, if you don't have diabetes, if you don't have blood pressure, if everything else is fine, then today the technology has advanced so much that even if you've attained your menopause, we can make you pregnant. That these women have used donor eggs to become pregnant. Because it is your uterus is fine, it doesn't age the way your eggs are aging. If I take a healthy donor egg, a healthy egg with from a healthy donor who is under the age of 30 and fertilize it with the, you know, the wife's or the husband's sperms and create an embryo and put it back into the wife, then she's going to get pregnant. Because the reason why she is not getting pregnant is her eggs are not good enough. Now there is a law, by law there are ICMR guidelines which is put the age of the woman as 50 years. So we cannot treat a woman above the age of 50. So under the age of 50, even 49 year old woman, very easy to make a pregnant. First attempt or chances with donor eggs to become pregnant is almost 60-65%. So it's very easy to make older women pregnant with donor eggs. For me particularly, what I find extremely challenging is making older women pregnant with their own eggs, with their own genetic material. This is where the real challenge lies. This is where the real satisfaction lies. So about the age of 40, I would say that I have treated many women successfully between the age of 40 and 45 with their own eggs. I would say that while undergoing IVF or any kind of infertility treatment, the key word is going to be moderation. You know, when you're trying to conceive, it is a very good time to get your health in a good shape. So, as far as your diet is concerned, you need to get onto a very good healthy diet, a high protein diet, add lots of fresh fruits, fresh salads, nuts in your diet. If you're a non-vegetarian, then grilled chicken, eggs. So, a lot of high protein things. You need to have a high protein diet, but nothing hard and fast. You know, don't be very stressed about your diet. Don't worry that you're going to put on weight during IVF. And, you know, no. It is, if you feel like some days, if you crave for a slice of pizza or, you know, a piece of dessert, go for it. Because basically, don't add stress. IVF or infertility is anyways a little bit stressful for patients. You know, they just tend to think a lot, but try and remain stress-free. So have a sensible diet in moderation. Exercise, there is again no reason that why you should be, you know, completely stop all your activities. No, you must continue your routine. And just during the stimulation phase, when you're taking those from your period, day one of your period till, you know, till the egg retrieval or be a little many few days beyond that, I would say don't do any heavy, high intensity exercises. You can definitely do gentle walks, restorative yoga, breathing exercises. So no aerobics, no cross training, no any high intensity exercises. That is a restriction that we would ask you to follow. Caffeine, you have to reduce your caffeine intake. Again, reduce it. The keyword is moderation. So if you're used to having two large cups of coffee, make it, you know, cut it down to two small cups of coffee. If you're having one large cup, then maybe you can just make it one small cup. If you want to travel during IVF, just a short weekend trip is okay. But, you know, any trip, any travel that is going to keep you away from your fertility team for more than 4 days should be avoided. Because we want to monitor you, we want to monitor the growth of your eggs, so you have to be available. But a short trip of 1 or 2 days should be fine. you know, as with everything, there are all sorts of people. We see women or couples who are very chilled out. You know, even if they are 36, 37, they'll come to us and they'll say that, okay, you know, we have now decided all these years we did not want to have children. You know, probably they were settling down in their career and now they've settled down and they feel that they want to have a child. And they say that, you know, we have come to evaluate ourselves, and you know, you tell us where we stand and what are the next steps, what we are supposed to do. So they take it very matter of factly. But then there are another set of patients who are just so stressful. You know, the minute they walk in, there is stress written all over their face, and they start talking and they'll say that, you know, my periods have been irregular since I was a child and I'm so worried. So, you know, irregular periods is one of a very common symptom for PCOS girls, PCOD women. And PCOD is a very common condition for Indian girls. But there is nothing to stress about. It can all be sorted out with very basic treatments, very basic interventions.